What's up, guys? It's your girl Angie B with Baller Alert, and we are here with Drumma Boy, and we're getting ready for Baller Talks. I see all of your awards behind you. Yes, we love to see it. My boy's taking a sip of his drink. We love it.
Oh, yeah. It's a blessing, man. Hey, yeah, boy. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to Baller Alert for having me. What's happening?
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Happy to have you here. You're getting ready to, you know, release an album. You launched an app, so you're doing a lot of different things. Grammy winner Ludacris and Latin artist Snow is on your upcoming album, Drumma Boy and Friends. And who else can we expect and anticipate on this album?
Oh man, I just did a record with T.I., Ty Dolla $ign, Wiz Khalifa. I'm super excited about that. I got Gucci and Dolph on the record. I got Ro James. I've been working with a little bit of everybody, you know what I mean? The Young Breeds, you know what I'm saying? No Cap, been working with him, trying to get something that's solid for the project, as well as reaching out to the heavy hitters like Travis Scott's, the 2 Chainz. So, you know, it's a plethora and a collage of talent. The gurus, the OGs, of course, Ballin' G's, Drumma Boy and Friends, man. So Gangsta Boo, you know, people who really, you know, a part of my life, a part of my career, you know what I mean? Rocco, we're going to go in and do a joint, you know what I'm saying? And really just delivering, which I really been missing. Like, you know what I mean? The game been missing Luda for so long, you know what I'm saying? And it's like, man, just bringing the best out of who you been missing. I did a joint with Tink and Twista, you know what I mean? I'm excited about, so you know what I mean? We probably gonna put Shauna on that record, just all of the Chicago talent. So, you know, it's a blessing to just make certain sounds and capture certain culture.
Yes, you have so many of our faves on this. I'm excited. a release date.
You know, I was pushing hard for this Christmas, and it's like the label is like, yo, like you coming so big, you coming so crazy. They want me to kind of push into, you know, 2022, you know, aiming towards around March. So, you know, if I had to me personally put a date on it and push myself for a date, I'm aiming for 311.
Okay. Okay, that works. That works.
Friday, March 11th.
Awesome. Okay, cool, cool, cool. So you recently launched your own app with exclusive content. What's different about your app and what makes it exclusive?
My app is exclusive content from me, not particularly everything that I'm going to go straight to Instagram with, but, you know, master classes, you know, motivational talks, being able to ask me direct questions, going live with me while I'm in the studio with, you know, upper echelon, A-plus tier artists, you know what I mean? And being able to also tap into my podcast, Beauty and the Beats podcast, hosted by myself and Dime Peace, both of us born and raised out of Memphis, and being able to deliver a voice on the struggle, the ups, the downs of the industries, the entertainment business, and just getting some game from some OGs, you know what I mean? So, I mean, it's so many different things that I do that I think the app allows me to deliver to my fans and really get that Drumma Boy experience.
Yes, I love that. That gives a very personal relationship for your fans to have with you. And people don't get that often. So kudos to you. Congratulations.
Yeah, for sure.
Out of working with music favorites like the Migos, Wale, Gucci Mane, Ace Hood, and more, who would you say surprises you in the studio the most?
I always get a surprise out of Gucci. You know what I mean? Me and Gucci just making music in the studio was always, you know, just fun. You know what I mean? And you don't know, like, what kind of song you're going to make, but I know we make a hit every time. You know, Rocco the same way, like, you know what I mean? It's just fun. It's we in there having fun and just doing what we do. 2 Chainz. It's so many guys, like, I think me too is like a lot to do with me, how I bring the best out of whoever I work with. So it's like, regardless if you shy or if you quiet or if you, you know, normally don't talk a lot or whatnot, you know what I mean? Some people don't write unless it's, you know, one or two people in the room and just real private. Some people write better with no one in the room. But I think with me, you know, I'm trusted and I give this inspiration. I give this melody, I give this hop, I give this bounce, I give this flow, you know, I give this advice, you know, in life, or, you know, I give this quote or this bar, you know what I mean? Or I give the energy and jump in the booth myself and just, you know what I mean? And like I did with the Ludacris record, that's me on the hook with I never thought in my life I'd be on a record with Luda and Snow the Product, and here it is, like I'm on the hook. They was like, yo, this is crazy, like, you know what I mean? So for me to inspire and motivate people in that way, you know, that's what I'm here for. Yes,
absolutely, we love to hear it. And what R&B artist is catching your ear right now, and why?
Man, Summer Walker, SZA, you know, both of them, it sounds like home. It sounds like, you know, Drumma Boy fit right in there. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? We gotta make some magic. Those are two people that I, you know, Ella May, Janae Aiko, you know, all of those beautiful ladies are just people that, you know, really inspire me and motivate me, and you know, even her, it's like seeing her play that guitar, play that bass, you know what I mean? Chloe Bailey, to see her produce those records, and then I seen one record she was producing lately that sounded like some Drumma Boy. I said, man, look how they give her the game. She in there making beats. Like, that's what inspires me, seeing our beautiful ladies really making magic, making big records. Those are the ones that I want to collab with, work with, and put some hits on the board with.
Yes, absolutely. All of those are my favorite, literally, in the list.
So,
thank you. What inspired your boutique store? We see that you're into fashion, and you chose the location of Atlanta. Why?
I live here. I can keep my hands on it, keep my eyes on it, be involved with it. You know, it's a lot of inventory to keep safe, you know what I mean? And, you know, just to be involved. Like, I worked at the shoe store just for feet growing up. I've always had that passion for fashion and just making people happy, whether it's through cooking, whether it's through making beats, whether it's through, you know, selling clothes that they like or whatever, just being able to come through for people in the last minute. A lot of guys come to Atlanta. It's the most traveled through city in the South. So when guys come through and they got a show, you know, they might get in town 9:30, the malls are closed. So us being open 10:30 and having VIP, you know, appointments only for our VIP status and allowing them to come get their hair cut, you know what I mean? Get sharp and get dressed and ready to go for their show tonight, you know what I mean? And I've really come through for a lot of artists, whether it's through their music, whether it's through their fashion, whether it's through advice, knowledge, however I can deliver, uplift, and put us on a upper echelon. You know, that's what I'm here for. You know, a lot of Black designers, a lot of creative designs, you know, and it's so many people that, you know, we've empowered, you know what I mean? And taking these lines and say, hey, let me put it on. Whatever that is, it look good on me. I got you. You know what I mean? It's not about just the Gucci's and the Louis and the Fendi's and whatnot. I'm wearing black on. You know what I mean? I used to tell my mom all the time, like, you can put me in Walmart, I'm gonna come out fresh. Take me to Kmart, I'm gonna come out fresh. You know what I mean? You can put me in Ross, I'm gonna come out with something that's like, you know what I mean? And it's we in a whole different level now that you see, you know, especially when a lot of the malls were closed down during COVID, and a lot of people who own stores couldn't even get in their stores. So I chose this location because it was a standalone, it was a house, and I was like, I'm gonna do something different and make you feel at home. I'm always one of those guys that want to make you feel at home, Southern hospitality, and change the concept. You know what I mean? And House of Fresh. Check out our Instagram at House of Fresh ATL, man. Visit our website, houseoffresh.online.
Yes, absolutely. Yes, absolutely. We love what you're doing with the community, and even you allowing, you know, these celebrities to come when they come into town and get them dressed and get them a fresh cut. That's amazing. So.
Oh yeah, and we support all of our own. Like I said, man, Pusha T, Play Clothes, T.I., Akul, Hustle Gang. You know what I mean? NBA Young Boy got a line. You know what I'm saying? Lil Baby, 4PF. You know what I mean? Anything that come out in the rapper world, you know what I mean? We the first ones on it. Jeezy has some TM103 and the Snowman merch and whatnot. You know, we getting our hands on the top black owned.
Yes. If y'all didn't know anything, Drumma Boy supports black owned businesses. Okay.
And I am a black owned business. You did.
Yes. And what piece of advice would you tell your 18-year-old self?
Piece of advice I tell my 18-year-old self, man, wake up. You know what I mean? Like understand that, you know, you are what they want. You know what I mean? It comes down to the beats and all of that. But when I really broke it down, it's the emotion that I have inside of me that it even helped me make them beats. So you got to understand who you are on the inside and deliver that. Don't hold back. You know what I mean? I'll be quiet. I'll be, you know, and a lot of times you quiet, you observing, you listening, you studying, you understand it. But at the same time, balance it. Listen, learn, but still be heard. Still be felt. You know what I mean? And to make your presence. You know what I mean? So, you know, for 5-10 years, you would hear my music, but you ain't never see my face. You ain't even know who I was. You just hear Drumma Boy, Drumma Boy, Drumma Boy, Drumma Boy. So it's just like a myth until they see it. Seeing is believing. So that's what I would say to my younger self.
Thank you so much, Drumma Boy. We appreciate it. That's a wrap for Baller Talk. And we'll make sure to get you all of the interviews.
Already, man. I appreciate y'all having me, man. Go get the new single, I Said What I Said, featuring Luda, Snow the Product, Drumma Boy, D-Boy Fresh. Hey, yeah. I produced Whitney Houston, Salute, which came from T.I. The album is on the wall. I turned my computer just so y'all can see that platinum album up there, Paper Trail. On the Paper Trail album, I produced You Ain't Missing Nothing. If you listen to You Ain't Missing Nothing, it's my live band, Drumma Boy Live. And at one point, R. Kelly had reached out, was like, yo, we need some music from you. I'm writing for different artists, da 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 da. A week later, after I sent him some material, as a matter of fact, 6 months later, after I sent him some beats, he hit me back like, yo, you got Whitney Houston's single. It's called Salute. So I'm like, man, damn, bro. I call moms. I'm calling everybody like, man, da 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 da. He calls me back the next day, plays me the beat. It's the same beat as You Ain't Missing Nothing. So I'm like, damn, Kel, you ain't hear a Paper Trail album? You know what I'm saying? I know you listen to Tip. I know you a fan of Tip. This Tip biggest album, you know what I'm saying? And it's 6 months later, you know what I mean? After I had gave him the beat, you know what I mean? So he probably wrote the song. You know, it take time. 3 months, 4 months go by, 5 months go by, blah, blah, blah. He probably ain't even listened to the Tip Paper Trail album. So he plays me the beat. And I'm like, damn, that's the same beat on T.I. Paper Trail album. So I like, shit, let me redo it or get my band in there to remake the music. And the person who we was talking to, I forget his manager's name, but his manager who we was talking to died of pneumonia. So I lose contact with Kel. You know what I mean? And Kel just like redid the beat on his own. Like he had his band replay the beat. So it's the same exact chords, the same exact keys, just a half a key up. So y'all go listen to You Ain't Missing Nothing, T.I., then go listen to Whitney Houston, Salute. It's the same music, man. And this is crazy because, like, I ain't never really trip or be like, man, you know, fuck R. Kelly and all this old hating that shit. I'm going to see you in these streets, nigga. Like, I'm just blessed to have that genius in me for you to put your name on my shit. You know what I mean? And it's like, you know, this album did 3 million. Whitney Houston album did 3 million too. The song Salute went platinum. with R. Kelly name on it. So I should, that all these men on the wall, Whitney Houston will be my first woman plaque. And it is my first woman plaque because I know it's my music. But more importantly, her spirit with me, man. You know what I mean? I'd rather have the spirit than the accolades. Look what's going on with my life. It's just
taking off.
You know what I mean? And look what's going on with Kelly. You know what I mean? It's like, man, you know what I mean? So you don't wish incarceration on nobody. You know what I mean? But man, listen, my message is karma's a motherfucker, dog. Don't put your name on no shit you ain't do. Don't claim no shit that you ain't goddamn do. That's my message to the people, bro. You know what I mean? If you did it, you did it. I did that. That was the only thing that a nigga ever took from me, period, ever in life. You know what I mean? And it's like, you know, sometimes you feel like, man, damn, that shit hurt. This and that, woo, woo, woo. But then I'm her spirit, she talked to me every day, man. She sent me a blessing every day. You know what I mean? So, man, put your name on what's yours. Drumma Boy, D-Boy Fresh.
You take care, no more.
Hold on, my bad. I'm going to just play you the first 10 seconds of each one.
Hey. Say, pimp.
The original.
Just everybody stretched out behind the wall.
My name on it. I got my plan.
Days on their calendar. Flip a page of month to month. I don't give a damn.
R. Kelly replayed it with his band. Put his name on it. And it's called Salute. So nigga wonder why I do this so much. Why I salute?
You say you don't
spirit
walk
with
away.
Me, my G.
You ain't got nothing to
I
say.
Appreciate that though, Kelly.
I salute
yeah. You too, my G.
Go on,
I salute you, Whitney. R.I.P. Whitney Houston, man.
No more tears to shed. What you
crazy.
That is insane. That crazy. Is insane. I can't believe that even happened to you. But like you said, your career has been taking off. You're doing
Even the fucked up shit that happened to you are the blessings in life. Those are still things that make you bigger and better than before. You know what I mean? So
come on, Jungle Boy, my dog.
Come on, man. Genius.
Thank you.